Hi to all. Today we will discuss how to draw an involute of a hexagon. Here, take the given question. Draw an involute of a hexagon of side 25 mm. The side length of the hexagon is 2.5 cm. As we know, hexagon has 6 sides. Okay, if any regular polygon or hexagon, all the lengths has same value and the angles at the corners also same. For doing the involute of a hexagon, we need to do the hexagon initially. Okay, for doing hexagon, I am using outer angle formula. This angle I am taking. Let us take it is theta. This is the outer angle. Okay. So we have one formula for doing any polygon by using this angle 360 by n, where n is number of sides of the polygon. In our case, it has 6 sides. Okay. Substitute in it 360 by 6. Each angle is 60 degrees. As I told initially, all the angles at the corners are same. And the outer angles also same. Outer angle is 60 degrees. Okay. And this side also outer angle is 60 degrees. Okay, if you extend this line, this angle is also 60 degrees. Okay, and if you extend here, this angle is also 60 degrees. Okay, like that, at all the corners, angles are same. Okay, if you extend it here, this angle is also 60 degrees. Okay, this angle. So let us do the hexagon initially. After that, we will do the involute. Here, first take AB length of 2.5 cm. Okay, let us do by using the instruments. The side is 2.5 cm. 2.5 mark end points and join it. Give the name A, B. After that, take the 2.5 cm line. This angle is 60 degrees, outer angle. So by using the protractor, take 60 degrees here. So in this direction, take 2.5 cm. So it is 2.5 cm. So this point is, I am taking C point. So after getting C, here take 60 degrees with this line. So at C point, I am taking 60 degrees. So in this direction, take 2.5 cm. So A, B, C and then it is a D. So after getting D, do the line with 60 degrees here. So at the D point, take again 60 degrees. Do the line 2.5 cm in this direction. Just extend the line on it, mark 2.5 cm. Make it dark. So up to here. This point is E point. After getting E, do the line 60 degrees here at E. So in this direction, take 2.5 cm. Just do some length here. On it mark 2.5 cm. So this is the F point. Now if you measure it, it should be 2.5 cm and this angle should be 60 degrees. Let us check whether it is 2.5 or not. It is 2.5. Now check this angle is 60 degrees or not. At A, take this angle. It is 60 degrees. So whatever polygon we did, it is correct one. After getting hexagon, here on sides, 6 sides also, extend the length. Extend this length, AB length, BC length, CD length, DE length, EF length and AF length up to some distance. Just do some length here. Here also do some length at all the sides. Okay, we don't know how much length, just extend it. And at CD also extend the length and DE also extend the length. And EF also extend it and AF also in this direction. Okay. After extending all the sides, So on the first side, okay, take the peripheral length of the hexagon on the AB length. Okay, consider this is the initial point, P point. Already we have marked it is B. I am taking one more point here, P point. Okay, I am marking P also. Okay, from P, take the peripheral length of this hexagon. So how much each side? 2.5 cm. Okay, it has 6 sides. So peripheral length is equal to 2.5 into 6. So it is 15 cm. So mark the peripheral length 15 cm from P point. Okay, by using scale, mark 15 cm on it. So here. Okay. Now take this point is Q point. PQ is the peripheral length of this hexagon. So after doing PQ length, divide this PQ length into 6 equal divisions. Why we are taking 6 divisions means here we are using hexagon. For hexagon, we have to divide this PQ into 6 parts. If you are taking pentagon, we have to divide PQ into 5 parts. If you are taking square, we have to divide PQ into 4 parts. So in our case, we have to divide PQ into 6 parts. As we know, this length is peripheral length, okay, 15 cm. So 15 cm we have to divide into 6 parts means each part is 2.5 cm. Okay, this length. So by using compass, I will take this length 2.5 cm. Divide, this is the first part and this is the second one. This is the third one. This is the fourth. Fifth is the sixth one. Okay, so 6 equal divisions we did. Mark this is intersection point is 1 dash. This intersection point is 2 dash. This one is 3 dash, this one is 4 dash, 5 dash, and this is 6 dash. Okay. Now here, after dividing into 6 equal divisions, take P6 length, that is PQ length, mark on the first line. Okay, whatever length is there, total length, we are marking here, the P6 length. Okay, on the first side, AB length, we are marking P6 length here. Okay, next take P5 length by using compass. Take the second length, that is BC length, mark on it as C as center, mark P5 length here. Just do bigger arc so that it is easy to join, so that we can do the curve easily. Take the intersection point, so we took P5, so mark here P5. After marking P5, next take P4 length by using compass. Mark on this side, CD side, okay. So D as center, just do bigger arc. And give the intersection point is P4. After marking P4 length, take next P3 length by using compass. Take the next side, mark from the E point. Take the intersection point is P3. After marking P3, next take P2 length by using compass. Okay. Now take this side, okay. So F as center, do bigger arc here. Take the intersection point is P2. After marking P2, take P1 length by using compass. Mark on this side. Okay, A as center. Just do an arc. Here join it. Okay, to the first point like this. And this side also extend up to some length. Okay, do an arc. So after getting all these points, if you join all P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 and P6 points, okay, to the initial P point and Q point, you will get involute. Try to do with freehand curve. Okay, here do the curve as it is, as I shown. Here just extend these arcs and join these two arcs. And here, so join P2, P3. Try to do bigger arcs here, okay, so that it is easy to join. Here mark the given dimension. AB length of the hexagon is 25 mm and PQ is peripheral length, and this curve is called an involute for the given hexagon.